Welcome class. Hope you all are fine at home. Now, in the previous class, we have discussed about the northern mountains of our country. And in this class today, we are going to discuss about the states which will come in our country, which are lying between the north to east. So here, what all the states are there, which will cover under the north direction to the east direction, we are going to discuss in this class. So hope you are ready with your pencil. Semester book and eraser. Now, the first state always which will be at the north direction, that is the Jammu and Kashmir. Next south direction of the Jammu and Kashmir, here we have Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram and Tripura. About these states we are going to discuss in this class. Now, every state has one particular importance. Now, how our Hyderabad is famous for Golconda Fort, for Charminar, for Tangdar. In the same way here, these states also have some speciality. Now here, about these states we are going to discuss about the places to visit. The important tourist places where most of the visitors from the other countries and from our country also, they will visit these places, especially in the summer season. And about the culture and occupation also we are going to read in this class. Now, the first state, the states in the Himalayan region. So, these all places will come under the Himalayan ranges. The states of Himalayan region and this is from page number 357. Right? Now, the Jammu and Kashmir. Now, first we are going to discuss about the Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir is the northernmost state of India. The state has two capitals. How many capitals are there for Jammu and Kashmir? There are the two capitals, that is Srinagar during the summer months and Jammu during the winter months. So, Jammu and Kashmir having how many capitals is very important question even for your exam also. So, Jammu and Kashmir having the two capitals, that is Srinagar is the summer capital and Jammu is a winter capital. So there is only one state which is having the two capitals. That is, Srinagar is a summer capital and Jammu is a winter capital. Now, the Indus, Tavi, Ravi and Chenab are the important rivers flow through these states. The La, the Dar and the Ular are the two famous lakes of the state. How we have the artificial lake in our Hyderabad? In the same way here, in the Jammu Kashmir here we have the two important lakes, that is Ular and Dar Lake. Ular and Dar Lake. Lake means our water body. So the Lake Ular is the Asia's biggest lake. So here we have the seven important continents. Among the all seven continents, especially in the Asia's largest continent. Now in our Asian continent, the Ular Lake is the biggest lake. The Dar Lake is full of beautiful houseboats, some of which are also used as hotels for tourists. Here you can observe. Yeah, most of the people who are in the northeastern states will go for the sightseeing. The boats will be like this. Completely house type boats you can observe better, you can see. It is completely, it looks like a hotels. Right? It will be in the water. And here you can see such type of boats where the people will be living in the boat. Right? Now these boats are very famous and not only in the Jammu and Kashmir, even in in our Kerala, which is a southern southern state. In that state also we are able to see people who are living in the boats. Now here, the flat bottom wooden boats are called shikharas. Here, the flat bottom here, the huge boat where we will be having a very big hotels in that we call as a ship. Example, Titanic ship, you remember. But this is not a Titanic ship, but it is a boat which is made with a wooden. These boats we call as a shikhara. Right? The wooden boats are called as a shikharas. Now, which will float in the lake. People sell fruits, vegetables and flowers from these shikharas. Now, most of the people are living in the shikharas as they will stay in the shikharas as a guest. And the shikharas are also called as small quarters for the small family members. So here, the people who are going from one place to another place or who are living in the shikhara, and the vegetable sellers, the fruit sellers, the flower sellers, everyone will be walking or doing the business only with the help of the shikharas. It will be really easy for them to attract the common people. And not only the common people but also for the tourist people also they will attract. Now, what are the important places to visit? Now, here the people who are coming from the other states to our state, that is to our Hyderabad, they will first visit to the Golconda, Salajan Museum, right? And further Charminar. So, in the same way, the people whoever is coming from the other states and going to the Jammu and Kashmir, first they will visit the important sightseeing places which we are going to read now. Srinagar, Gulmarg and Pahalgam are the famous tourist places of the state. People go to Gulmarg for skiing and ice skating. Skiing, even in your TVs also you have watched. Right? Here, with the help of the two sticks, the people will do the complete sightseeing or they will move from one place to another place on the ice land. The state is also famous for gardens such as the Shalimar Bagh, Rishabh Bagh and Chashme Shahi and Indira Gandhi Tulip Garden. So here these are the important places which can be seen in the Jammu and Kashmir. Now the state is also famous for its own holy places and temples such as the Shankaracharya Temple, Amarnath Caves, Vaishno Devi Shrine and Raghunath Temple. So these are the important places, not only the sightseeing places but also here we have the very famous temples to go and perform the rituals. Now about the culture and occupation of the Jammu and Kashmir. The people of Kashmir wear long loose woolen coats called firan. So here the long coats which will be worn by the Jammu and Kashmir people we call as a firan. Firan is nothing but a long coat. Both men and women wear it with a salwar. Now, the people of the state like to eat rice, rajma, meat and fish. Why rajma, meat and fish beta? Why? Because here these people are living in a cold climatic conditions. To keep themselves warm, they eat the food which gives the heat to their body. So that's why they prefer to eat rice, rajma, meat and fish. They drink a special tea called khawa. Special dress, long coats is known as firan and the tea is known as khawa. Now, the people speak several local languages apart from Hindi and English. Kashmiri, Pahari, Balti, Gojri and Tadri. These are the different languages where they will speak among their community people. The main occupations of the people of the state are farming, sheep rearing and weaving. Pashmina goats found in the high altitudes of the Himalayas are great for the fine Pashmina wool. Now here the Pashmina goats are very famous because they are very good for giving the wool have learned about the Jammu and Kashmir. Hope you have understood this. Now moving to the next one, that is about the Himachal Pradesh. Where we have the Himachal Pradesh here? Just in the south direction of the Jammu and Kashmir, here we have the Himachal Pradesh. Now, Himachal Pradesh lies in the northern mountains south of the state of Jammu and Kashmir. The capital of Himachal Pradesh is Shimla. What is the capital of Himachal Pradesh? Shimla. Not the Shimla beach, but it is a Shimla. It's the capital of Himachal Pradesh. Now, Himachal Pradesh is famous for beautiful tourist places. How Jammu and Kashmir is famous for the tourist places, the same way the Himachal Pradesh is also famous for the tourist places. They are Kulu, Manali, Shimla, Dalhousie and Dharamshala. So here we have five important tourist places. They are Kulu and Manali, Shimla, Dalhousie and Dharamshala. And here Chain, a hill station in the state, has the two world's highest cricket ground and is also considered a hiker's paradise. Not only the five important tourist places, but also here we have a Chain. It is a world's highest cricket ground. The important weapon that we use in the cricket, that is bat. Yes, Anna, but now in this longer period, you people are playing the cricket with your family members at your home. Yes, sir? No. Now here for the cricket, we require a goat. We require a bat. Now for this, we require a very huge ground, especially for our cricket players. Now the chain, which is in the Himachal Pradesh. Now, Chain is the biggest ground across our universe. That is the world highest cricket ground is in our country, that is in Himachal Pradesh. Now, this we call as a hiker's paradise. Hiker's paradise. Right? Now, about the culture and the occupation of Himachal Pradesh. The people of Himachal Pradesh wear bright colored clothes, right? Means very dark colored clothes. Women wear kurta and pajama and a scarf on the head. And they will be wearing the scarf like this, right? Now, rice, maize and vegetables form important part of the staple diet of the people. So, how we have the meat, fish, rajma and rice in the Himachal Jammu and Kashmir. In the same way, rice, maize and vegetables are the important part of the diet. Patir and chow are some of the important dishes of the state. Now, every state will be having the one particular food which is considered as a staple diet. In the same way, here also we have the patir and chow. Patir and chow. Right? Now, the people of Himachal Pradesh love folk dance, folk music and dance. But the western classical music will be different and the folk music will be different. Here, the Himachal Pradesh people like to perform on the folk music. Some of the most commonly spoken languages include Hindi, Punjabi, Pahari, Dogri and Kamli. The people of Himachal Pradesh are mainly involved in agriculture. The Jammu and Kashmir are very good in taking care of animals, breeding, rearing. And Himachal Pradesh people are good in agriculture. Why? Because here we have the plain areas where they can be able to do the agriculture very easily. But the Jammu and Kashmir, the most part of the land area is covered with the snow. So in these climatic conditions, growing the food crops and the to do the agriculture is very difficult. So the people who are in the Himachal Pradesh, they prefer to do the agriculture. Now next, the main crop crops grown here are wheat, maize, rice and barley. Fruits such as the plums, peaches, apricots, pomegranates and apples. Here you can able to see an apple where it is very famous, which are grown in the Himachal Pradesh. Here you can able to observe the beta. This is a apple. Now here daily if we eat one apple in a day, here we can able to prevent ourselves from different health issues. So that here we can able to avoid going near to the doctor. Now the fruits such as the plums, peaches, apricots, pomegranates and apples are grown here. Now people are also involved in toy making, wood carving and shawl weaving. Not only the shawl weaving, but also the people are very good in weaving the mufflers. Here you can able to see the muffler. Yes or no? Especially in this seasons, in this winter season, we can able to prefer to wear the shawl. Yes or no? And in the early morning, most of the old people, they will prefer to wear the mufflers. They will completely, they will put like this in the early morning and they will go for the walk. And here, these are very famous mostly in the north states, northern states of our country, because they are completely coming across with the different climatic conditions. Now, moving to the Uttarakhand. Hope you have understood about the Himachal Pradesh. Now, we are going to discuss about the Uttarakhand. Here we have Uttarakhand. Right? Now Uttarakhand is situated in the northern part of India. Again, this also comes under the north direction. So this state comprises the mountainous regions of Garhwal and Kumaon. The capital of Uttarakhand is Dehradun. Right? The capital of Uttar Pradesh is Dehradun. Now, what are the important places to visit in Himachal? Sorry, in Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand is famous for hill stations and pilgrimage centers. Hill station means just now we have discussed is Kulu, Manali, these all are the hill stations. And pilgrimage place means where the people will worship. Pilgrimage means worshipping place. Right? Now, the Mussoorie, Nainital and Rani Khet are some of the famous hill stations of this state. Now, the famous places of worship of the state are Gangotri, Yamunotri, Badrinath and Kedarnath. Now here in Himachal Pradesh, there we have the Vaishno Devi temple. And here in the Uttarakhand, here we have Gangotri, Yamunotri, Badrinath and Kedarnath. So the Hemkund Sahib, an important pilgrimage center of Sikhs, is in Uttarakhand. Now here, a famous temple for the Sikh people. Here we have the different religions in our country. Even though we people are different in performance, the different rituals, but here we all are considered as a part of India. Now, in Uttarakhand, in Dehradun, here we have the Hemkund Sahib. Hemkund Sahib, a famous temple for the Sikh people. Now, about the culture and occupation of the Uttarakhand. Now, Hindi, Kumaoni, Garhwali and Bhotia are some of the languages spoken in this state. Now, Kafuli, Fanha, Harsa and Gulgula are popular dishes of Uttarakhand. Yeah, these names are completely different. Yeah, what are idli, dosa, sambar, vada, puri, is there in the South India. Yeah, these are the different dishes which are referred to the different states. Now, the main occupations of people here is agriculture. How the agriculture is famous in the Himachal Pradesh? In the same way, the Uttarakhand people also prefer to do the agriculture. Now, the tourism also adds to the economy of Uttarakhand. Now, here the people who all are going to the Uttarakhand, yes or no, even the all whatever they are spending in Uttarakhand, that is also a part of developmental activities which that taking place in the opera Khani. Now whenever we visit to the zoo, we pay some ticket amount to the person. What is the use of the why they are collecting them? To take care of the complete zoo and the animals and the taking care of everything in the zoo. So in the same way, we also the people whoever is visiting Uttarakhand, they pay some amount. That amount will be used as a good source. The amount is used for the good development activities of the tourist places. Now tourism also adds to the economy of Uttarakhand. Oil seeds, pulses and sorrels are some of the major crops grown in Uttarakhand. Oil seeds means like mustard seeds. We'll say raya no beta. That oil seeds also will be grown in the Uttarakhand along with the normal food crops. Now, till here, Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand, these three important states will come under the north direction. Now we have few more states are there which will come under the northeastern states. They are Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Tripura, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Manipur and Nagaland. Now about these all states we will do in the next class. Hope you have understood this. Now please copy down the homework.
Take care. Thank you.